Frankenchrist album that put me on trial on Obscenity and Ellie. It was there, and the gallery owner was shutting them off so important people wouldn't see the scary stuff. Giger was furious. And then he finally hit behind the doors. Important people showed up with a metal mask on, going rawr at everybody. And then Carcass fans began showing up. The gallery guy wants to start charging $20 even to come up the elevator to admission. Giger's getting madder and madder. Then who walks into the gallery in full costume but GWAR? And this miserable Upper East Side gallery owner fled his own opening. He was so upset. Giger, however, was so happy to see GWAR. It made his night. Pulling a fish out of Lacey Peterson, remember that murder? With a lit cigarette in its mouth was bad enough, then out comes this indescribably hideous green baby that had me falling on the floor. I was laughing so hard. So sick, so wrong, and so GWAR. A developmentally disabled Toltec fetish gone horribly wrong that turned out to be a simple piece of green foam that Dave said he'd carved one day in about 15 minutes when he was born. I'm honored to this day that GWAR invited me to play Boss Glom in the Skullhead Face movie. And after shooting a bunch of stuff where I'd go back and forth with Sleazy P. Martini, yeah, the last take was when I would tear off the latex mask that took 8 hours to apply as I kind of blew up and turned into the Skullhead Face robot. Yeah. And they had a hose under me, and as I was tearing it off, French dressing and rotten cottage cheese was coming in with such force, I never knew my sinuses could get that big. Then there was more, and I thought my head really was going to explode. Again, the screams were real. By then, GWAR and the slave pit were family to me. I had come to know there was much more to Dave than the life of the party who just had to make fun of everything and everyone. That beneath it all was a kind and caring human being. Like when he went out of his way to look after and take care of my good friend Donovan when she was badly injured in a car crash. Winston Smith and I treasured the times we hung out with Dave and the gang, plotting all sorts of twisted, indefensible art crime. Dave once told me, or more than once, he really wanted me and him to go up to the ranch land Winston has way back in the woods in Mendocino County, just let it all go, kick back, and pick each other's brains. It meant the world to me that Dave and Don and Mike Bishop, among others, came to my new band, Guantanamo.